In Oregon, there's state rules that say every city needs to have a comprehensive plan, and that's your plan for how you're going to grow and develop. And there's many components that make up the comprehensive plan. So we have a policies document that gives goals and policies for our land use. And then we have more detailed plans that kind of expand on that. So for example, transportation plan or parks master plan, a plan for our airport, and all those together make up our comprehensive plan. So the city has a current comprehensive plan, but about 4 years ago, the council decided that it was time to take a fresh look at it. And you know, lots of people are moving to Salem. We have a lot of development happening, which you know if you drive around town, live in Salem. And so they funded a new comprehensive plan project, which we call Our Salem. And we spent about the last 3 years working on it, doing lots of outreach in the community, going to community groups, neighborhood associations, having a committee and looking at what are our goals and policies moving forward, what's our vision, where do we want to go, and how do we need to change our plans to get there. Well, the first reason we need a comprehensive plan is the state says we have to have one. But really, we need it because we need to make sure that we know as a community, as a city, as an organization, where we're going, where we want to go, and that we have something to measure our decisions against. So, for example, if I'm going to bring forward an amendment to change the zoning ordinance, I have to demonstrate how it complies with a comprehensive plan. So I can't, wildly change city policy on any given topic if what we've decided as a community is that this topic's really important to us. The comprehensive plan is about how we're going to grow and develop in the future. You may not think about the decisions that are made in your day-to-day life, but they definitely impact your day-to-day life, right? If you're a citizen of Salem, you definitely probably drive down our roads, walk or bike, or take your son, you know, to school, use a city park. All those things are detailed in the comprehensive plan as far as what are our goals and policies around those, and then how are we going to achieve them? I would say livability, and it, you know, expands on that, like how is it livable for everybody? Like how can we make the community affordable for people at all income levels? How can we ensure that there's enough land for people to have businesses that then provide jobs to our community? How can we make sure there's enough land for our schools, for our parks, that we're protecting our water system? All those things that you think about that make it a community that you want to live in. The zoning code implements the comprehensive plan. It says, for example, in the comprehensive plan, we're going to protect our natural resources. And the zoning code is where we have the actual regulations that we apply. All those different technical aspects that we apply to development are in the zoning code. So even though the broad ideas are in the comp plan. Well, the zoning map is where you would start to figure out what's my property zone. So whenever you ask a question, you're thinking about what can I do on my property, the first thing is look at the zoning and then look at the standards that apply in that zone. So we have a zoning map, lots of bright colors. You can go online and look up your zone and it will tell you, am I a commercial zone? And if so, am I commercial retail or commercial office or commercial general? And there's different uses allowed in different zones. And then there's different, we call it development standards. And that's really, again, how you can build, you know, the height, the setback, etc.